everyone, my name is Barbara. You can call me the girl who trades. In today's video, I want us to have a quick chat. This like a real chat about how to manage your emotions and yourself when you are losing on the Forex market and how to deal with the losing streak. This video, really, I just want to share what I have learned over this last couple of weeks. I've had a few losses in succession, and I just want to share what I have, how I've been managing myself, and hopefully someone will learn something from this video. So I've been having a few losses these last couple of weeks. I think I've taken a screenshot or something. If I find it, I'll put it somewhere in the video. But I've come to realize that in Forex trading, losses are normal. It's part of the game. You'd definitely have some losses as you're trading, but the most important thing is how you manage yourself and how you manage your trades when you're on a losing streak. And that is what will determine whether you will last long in Forex trading as a business, if I should put it that way. So for myself, the things that have helped me significantly when it comes to managing my myself and my emotions when it comes to risk management and losing my trades is the fact that I try not to risk more than 1 or 2% of my account when I'm trading. Usually that's when I'm trading a significantly big account, but if I'm trading a smaller account and I kind of need more room, then the maximum I would ever risk on a trade is about 4%. What that does is that it means that if you're risking 1% per trade, you need to lose 100 trades back to back, like in succession, 100 trades in succession before you can blow your account. Now, if you're risking 20-30% of your account on one trade, in 2 or 3 trades back to back, your account is gone. And that is what most beginners struggle with. So in order to use the correct percentage per trade, I use the Baby Pips position size calculator. I'll put that in here somewhere. So you state specifically the percentage you want to risk, your account balance, you state the percentage you want to risk, you state your stop loss in pips, and then the currency pair that you're trading. And then it will give you how much the amount you are potentially going to lose on the trade, and then the position size you should use for that trade. This is so helpful. That's the first thing that helps me a lot. The second thing is the fact that I always use a risk to reward ratio of 1:2 or more. I hardly use a risk reward ratio of 1:1. This is because if I use a risk reward ratio of 1:1, it means that if I lose a trade, I earn as much the same amount as if I win a trade. And this can put you at break even. That means if you are winning the same number of trades as you are losing, that means you'll be at break even. But as soon as your losses exceed your wins, you'll be losing money. So that's one thing I do. I promised my next video is going to be on risk reward ratio and how to use it to grow your account. So my risk reward ratio on every trade is usually a minimum of 1:2. So at least if I win one trade, that I get twice the amount I would have lost if I had lost the trade. So I'll explain that more in my next video. So that's one thing that also helps me a lot. So it doesn't make me lose my capital, my trading capital, when I'm trading. It's very important to learn these two practices, and that's what to me is very helpful in my trading journey. That's patience and persistence. So you need to be patient with yourself. You need to be patient with your journey on the Forex market. Your knowledge that you're acquiring every day, there's something to acquire, so it's very important that you keep on learning, you keep at it, and continue to grow your account at your own rate. You're not in competition with anybody, believe me. And then persistence. The thing with Forex trading is that it takes out the weak-willed very quickly. If you don't have a strong will, the market will just sweep you out and leave the people who are ready to learn, ready to build. So you need to be persistent. For me, if I have a losing trade or a couple of losing trades in a week, at the end of the week, because I journal all my trades, at the end of the week, I just pick up my trading journal and then I go through what those trades were, both my wins and my losses, actually. I go through them. I try to decipher why those trades ended in losses, if I should have done something differently, or if I was still right with my strategy, but then the market does what it wants to do. One thing is, if you keep doing this and you realize that a particular type of trade, anytime you take it, it ends up in a loss, it can give you a sign that now you have to probably modify that trade a little bit. And so it's very, very important. It's very important as a trader, whether beginner or advanced, it's very important that you journal your trades and then revise them, learn from them. And then if you need to make modifications to your trading plan, you do that. I just wanted to share this. This is what I have been doing over and over. And then these last couple of weeks, I have really had to be very focused and learning, because I've had a few losses. And so I wanted to share that with you guys. Let me know in the comments if how you deal with having losing trades and how you manage yourself and your emotions. Let's discuss in the comment section. So thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you liked it. Please do subscribe to the channel, like the video, share it with your friends. Let them also learn something from my journey. Please follow me on Instagram, The Girl Who Trades, and on TikTok, The Girl Who Trades GH. I'm not on Telegram, I'm not on Facebook, I'm not on Twitter, and I do not manage accounts for anybody. So please beware of scammers. There are lots of them around. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. So till the next time, it's The Girl Who Trades.